Want to do it? Huh? You want to do it? Buddy? Buster. 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 You want to do it? What's up? Huh? What's going on? What's going here? Come on. Come on, buddy. You remember me, right? Buster. Buster, you remember. You remember, pal. Look at that. Everyone's out of the habit of it. So nobody's here. Nobody cares anymore, Buster. They don't care anymore, bud. Hey, buddy. Hi, pal. Hi, pal. Hi, buddy. Hi, buddy. What's going on? What's up, pal? Yeah? What's up, buddy? What's up, buddy? Come here, buddy. Buster. Buster. What's going on, pal? I know it's been hard. I've been away, right? Right. Right. Hi, buddy. Yeah. Look at that. Buster. 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 Huh? What's up, bud? Good? Are you good? Hey. Hey. Did you know you lose your, almost you lose your entire audience if you go away for less than a week? Did you know that, pal? I guess I told him I'd be away. So are you gonna, do you still feel like performing, pal? Huh? Yeah? But I'll do it. Right? Buster! Hey. Hi, pal. I missed you too, buddy. Ugh. That's why I come home, man. Maybe troll free? I doubt it. I doubt it. My fucking toes hurt, man. Whew. So maybe this was not helpful. Maybe it's not helpful for me. Maybe I should have just committed to being away. Where did everybody go? I guess everybody's okay now, right? Everybody's doing fine, right? Everything's good. Everyone's sane, locked down. Use whatever options you have at your disposal to maintain your sanity without hurting yourself or others, all right, fuckers? Am I too close? What's happening? Where are my friends? It's not really a new hairdo. It's just a wet. But I thought I'd check in because I had this time before I go to set. And I'm going to have coffee. And wait for my boots to dry. Buddy, what's up? Because we worked like late last night, man. Come on, man. Come on. Cat Stevens. I haven't meditated in a few days because I was on a roll with it, with the British guy. But it turns out my director of the movie's British, so I'm kind of expecting him to just sort of kick in. It's like, take a breath. Breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. But that's not what's happening. Coffee? Come on, man. Are you new in town? I use, this is just coffee.coop out of Wisconsin. So, it doesn't matter that I don't need to keep momentum, but I thought I would check in. It doesn't matter that everybody who was in the habit of doing this is now gone. That's what happens, man. Fair weather friends. What are you going to do? Too close? So I can give you a report. Glad you can do this because my kid can't go to school. That guy, right? So working, like, it's strangely, somehow or another, that, I got to set with the COVID protocols. And, you know, I was pretty freaked out when I took this gig, like, beyond freaked out about, you know, working. And now, like, that it's peak COVID, I was, like, even more. But, like, and now that I'm in it and I committed to it, what am I going to do, sit around and be completely consumed with fear? I can't do that. So it just sort of went away. We get tested 3 days a week. I got tested yesterday, negative. Everybody on set wears a mask, like, all the time. The way it works is there's two groups. There's people that apparently on this production that are being tested 3 times a week, and then people that get tested once a week. That's Zone B, the people further out on the sort of production chain. But all Zone A people get tested 3 times a week. So there is never a moment really when anybody on set is without a mask other than the actors during performing. And that's the way it is. And the work is the work. Yeah, I was very nervous about a lot of things, as some of you know. Yeah, it's a film. It's me, Andrea Riceborough, Andre Royo. Those are the two that I am primarily working with. I think there's One Kiss Later. And that's answering, is there any kissing? I think there's One Kiss. The project is called To Leslie. And we're shooting out in the high desert, really, northeast of here, out near Andrews Air Force Base. So occasionally a sonic boom will happen out of nowhere because they're testing some sort of military monster. Some kind of flying monster makes a big noise. But I was really kind of racked and freaked out. It's about an hour. This set is about an hour and 10 minutes away. So I'm happy that I'm driving back and forth to work. That makes me feel a little safer not to have to sleep in a hotel. Yeah. High desert, some New Mexico vibes, a little bit. And it feels like Texas. It's supposed to be Texas. It's supposed to be somewhere in, you know, in a kind of a small town, Texas. We shot in Palmdale for a while and everyone was like, what? I hate it here. And I was like, yeah. Yeah, it's not far from Palmdale. Allison Janney and Stephen Root are, yes, they play Dutch and Nancy. And I don't have much with them, but I have a little. It's really just me and Royo on fucking set, hanging out. Riceboro does her own thing with her assistant in the car, staying warm. She's a thin lady. But me and Royo are sitting around. I gotta be careful. Because I'm sitting there with Royo, and we're having laughs and talking the talk and talking shit. But he's fucking goddamn Bronx. Hey, Mark, what's up? How you doing? Mark, what is? Where you at? Where you at? And I got to do Texas. And you guys know me. I mean, if I'm talking to Bronx for an hour, I'm going to talk Bronx. Too close? So now Royo's sort of like, accent, get the accent, get it out. Come on. And, but it's fun. I mean, like, if there's somebody that's, like, good to hang out with on set, it's him. And it's just fucking beat up. All these fucking hotel sets. And I've been on many of them because when people want this kind of effect in show business to get, you know, that old beat up hotel, they got to go find them. And they're out there. And a lot of times people end up shooting at the same ones because these, you know, these people, the locations people make lists. But apparently, this one, it's not a Western, dude, no. It's about a woman who, it's basically about a woman who hits bottom pretty bad and comes back home where she's got some shameful past to deal with. Yeah, so, but these hotels are just nasty, dude. They're nasty. They're all nasty, sadly. Like the Glow Hotel, that one had a pool. That was double nasty because there's just sadness to them. And we're inside and we're sitting around trying to find some warmth. You know, the trailer's okay, but, you know, we're kind of hanging out in between scenes with, you know, other people's lives around us. You know, and then you're thinking, is there COVID all over everything? But there, you know, here's the one thing about the COVID and, you know, knock on wood. That you just hope that everything that's being done is precautionary. Like I said before, everyone's wearing masks all the time and there's people squirting and wiping. A lot of squirting and wiping just out of nowhere. People are like, hand sanitizer? Sure. Squirting and wiping. Masked squirting and wiping is what's happening. Yeah, we see there's some meth out there, man. Saw some, there's some wandering meth cowboys, you know, 40 degrees in their shorts, not quite knowing where they are, but continuing to move as their brain just fries. Why is that guy walking like that? Why is that guy outside? Why is it? It's like, this is a place where, you know, no one's outside. It's like, you drive, man. Just these random people, fucking meth ghosts, wandering. Are you being careful not to touch your face? Kinda. Squirting and wiping. I'm not sweating under the PPE, no, but it does kind of make you feel rashy. Yeah, where is his teeth? Humboldt County's like that. What, with the meth zombies? But so, in other news, people are starting to come around.
Whoa, no.
Oh, shit, man. Things fell down. I guess some of you are, what am I drinking? What? Who are you? I guess some of you missed the fun because you didn't know I'd be here. Buster, you want to do a second show? Second show, Buster? Huh? Yeah? Second show? What do you think? Come on, buddy. Where's the love? Yeah, I know. I'm not home all day. What's up? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? Yeah? Come on, man. You got it in you. Buster. 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 Come on, man. I'm away all day. Come on, buddy. Yeah. 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 What's up? Come on. Give it up, man. Give it up. Wag it. Yep. Let's hear some noises. 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 Buster. Buster. Yeah. Huh? What? What? What's up? What's up? Buster. Yeah. Buster. Hey. Yeah. Okay. There you go. everybody all right? I found it. It was essential this morning that I somehow needed to wash my boots. I had to fucking saddle soak these. Now I'm going to fucking oil them up. That was the important work. I don't have a lot of lines today. It seems like a lot of like beats that are not dialogue beats. But Buddha face. Fuck, man. Today, Brad Williams is on WTF. Where we at, man? I've not seen the Frank Zappa deck. Does it feel good to interact with real humans? It's great. It's great. Every day you drive in, you get checked temperature. But I was so paranoid that, like, and I still am, really. Michael Morris is the director. You know, I'm just paranoid that, like, you know, I don't know what I'm doing, you know, and that I'm not really good. And I'm just like, you know, it's hard for me to think that, like, that I'm doing, you know. And I still don't, I don't know what day it is. It's Thursday. It's about an hour and 10 minutes. And I don't, like, I don't know, like, I worked really hard on putting the accent in, but there's some words and they're not right. And sometimes, I don't know. But here's the deal. It's like, here's how fucked up my brain is. I'm fucking showing up for work. Like, I've been doing this a long time. I've been on, you know, I have my own series for years. And, you know, I'm under the radar, right? Not too many people know me too close. But I definitely know how to be on a set. I've done enough movies, enough TV. So, like, there's a second nature to it. And I love it. I have to remember that. But here's the deal. I'm doing the scenes, man. I'm doing the scenes. I'm in it. You know, when I'm doing a scene, I'm not thinking about, like, is this good or is this bad? I'm in it, all in, you know? And there's these moments where they're shooting on fucking film, dude. So, like, when they say check the gate, they mean it. Isn't that crazy? Check the gate. Usually that's just something they say. But they're really checking the gate. My lips are all fucking chapped. It's been dry here. But the people thing is great. The food thing, that's another issue. So yeah, so they hire me. And so we're doing these takes. It's usually me and Andrea. We did a big fucking scene last night, late, in the cold, just me and her. And she's all beat, you know, all beat up, and she's a trip, man. So when we move on, right, they check the gate to make sure the film is still going through, I think. Ask somebody on here who knows about cameras. When you're working with film, you check the gate to make sure, I think, you got the take, or that the film is still threaded, or, you know, whatever. It's a film camera word, but they still say it. So now you have to check the gate, you know, to make sure you got the shots. So someone ought to talk to, someone answer them. I'm not exactly sure. But anyways, here's how I'm fucking, I haven't seen Jenny yet. I don't know when we shoot that. Make sure it's clean. There's not hair in there or a bug. Like, one of the film cameras went down last night. We've been shooting on one camera for a week or however long I've been there, 3 days. And we're doing a twofer, right? We had two cameras yesterday because there was this big barbecue scene or something. What do you mean, or something? I was there. And we're dealing with film cameras, and the film got fucking jammed. We're doing this scene. I heard a noise I never heard before. Just like, I'm like, what's going on? Film jam. Oh my God, time travel. Time travel. So we were down a camera. You're waiting, when are you going to play guitar? I recorded that thing the other night, so I'm probably not going to do a guitar thing till Sunday. We'll do it. But what was the point? It's like, when we do these scenes, you know, there's a lot of moving parts. I'm driving a truck. Got her, got Royo doing the thing. But there's always this part of me where, you know, I know when I'm in it. But he knows why he hired me. I don't know why he hired me. He hired me for my face. He likes the way my face emotes. So, it's that Danny Trejo story. You guys know that story? So anytime it's like, cut, we got it. There's part of me that's sort of like, did you though? How come I'm not getting more notes? Why, like, in my mind somewhere, in my dumb fucking head, right? It's like that he's given up on me. He's like, wow, this is a disaster. We're just going to have to focus on these other two and, like, hope for the best. That's where my brain goes after a day. Like, I'm not getting a lot of notes. Yeah, he's like, this is hopeless. Let's just keep the focus on Andrea and Andre. I don't think that's the case, though. I'm very good at adjustments. Like, I just have this, like, you know, when he gives me notes, I'm like, okay. He's like, do you think you could take that beat and just, like, you know, let it sink in a little bit? Yeah, I got it. Go, get out. I got it. Do you think when he says that he means, yeah, I hear you. I know, go, get away. It's like that, It's like that thing that, who is it? What's that guy's name? My brain's going. The guy's got the same name as the Aerosmith guitar player. And now I can't remember either of them. Brad Whitford. He was like, that's my meditation voice. Yes, but it's a British director. So in my mind, I guess all Brits have that voice. What did Whitford say about getting direction? An actor getting direction. He's like, your first thought is, fuck you. And your second thought is, fuck me, I suck. And then your third thought is like, okay, what you want me to do? Brad Whitford. Happiness quota just went up a bit, did it? I haven't done that many roles. I don't know if I have a favorite past role. What time is it? Show my kitties. Dude, you're late. I showed them twice. What do we got to do? Oh, today, Brad Williams, the dwarf. I've met my dwarf quota for the year with Brad Williams on the show. I'm so happy we can say the word dwarf. And you'll find that when I interview Brad Williams, a little person, that I'm very thrilled to be talking comfortably with a little person. Oh boy. Did I like doing Dr. Katz? What's with all this porny guy? What am I missing there? Did I like, 736, yeah. When does the Sam Talent episode come out? In the next couple of weeks. I think I'm going to try to read... I'm going to do a chapter for his audiobook. Q4. Yeah, you like Densmore? I got to leave at 8:30, and I think I... Oh, do you want to see my travel bag for my set work? Would that be interesting? Do you want to see how I make the sausage? Look. This is what I... This is what I bring. I fucking freak out and panic. Load this up for my trailer. I've got my... You got to have these in case the makeup person doesn't have them. Floss sticks. Gums. I got to get more of this because I brush my teeth in my trailer because your mouth gets gross. This is some nice tea that Andrea gave me. It's an Earl Grey tea, and it was very nice of her to give it to me. That's a Michael Caine type of Cockney. Oh, what am I doing? This is for my bad decisions. Valtrex. In case I get it, feel the tingle on my lip, I got my Valtrex. I got my cord. I got my paste. I got my fucking this. I actually like this CBD oil for my bad toes. Why floss sticks? Because, I don't know what happened to my mouth, but I can't eat anything with half the meal not getting... There's my watch. I don't know why that's in there. Getting stuck in my teeth. This was Lynn's. I found this. Not that it's like some sort of nostalgic memento. And then there's a protein powder. And, like, you know, there's just this stuff. Like, so I can at least lay this out when I'm in the trailer. Make sure I have gum. Make sure I can charge my phone without putting it on, you know, like the... I got to get more mouthwash. And just have the Valtrex just in case. It's been a while since I got one. But I get paranoid about a lot of things when I'm shooting. Where are your bags of wires? I don't have any more. If I do, they're out in there. They're out in the fucking garage. Yeah, gotta have the herpes medicine just in case. Souvenirs from hell. I've had that shit forever, but I don't get as many of the outbreaks anymore. My problem with the fucking herps is that, like, and I don't want to will it, so maybe we shouldn't talk about it. But when I fucking get one, dude, it looks like I got hit in the fucking mouth too close. Like, he's always in the same place. And, like, there have been times where it's like, did someone hit you with a bat? No, this is a fucking cold sore. But, have I ever reached out to Nicholson? Nah, there's no reaching out to Nicholson. He just does what he wants. He's not doing anything anymore, unless he really wants to. What was Jules Weather? Love Jules Weather, yes. Hey, Buster. Buster. Hey, oh, play some Thin Lizzy. What's up? Yeah? You have condom? I don't have condoms, no. I don't think I've worn a condom in 2 decades. All right, so what are we doing? Do you want to do this? Was it Q something? Do I owe somebody? Q4. All right, well, now I've got to do it. Man, it's not like I got work to do, man. Let's see. Q4, huh? I'm a little curious about this Jerry Jeff Walker record. But let's play the game. Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want to be part of that? I'm going to just go do it, okay? Believe me, there's not that many cues. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's Queen, man. There's no way they're not going to pick it up. It's Queen. I can't do Queen. What about Jeff Goldblum? He's been on my show. Give me another number. L7, we've done so many L's, man. We always do L's, and that's probably going to be Zeppelin, man. It's Frozen. We're in limbo. I'm sorry, man. I don't know what to tell you. I have nothing to do with the lag. Is it back? Hi, Buster. B11. Okay. I'll try B11. B11. I can't believe I'm playing games, man. I'm getting it. You want to be part of this? Just play Thin Lizzy. Okay, B. Oh yeah, I think we can get away with this. What is going on with that lighting? Yeah. The band. We got the band. Live. What is the first one in this album? Alright. I'm in. Okay, this definitely won't get tagged, I don't think. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, bring it out. Leave on. Rick. Danko rules. Yeah. Whee, there they are, man. Danko. Danko! Get on it, Levon! Woo! Rock and roll! Rock and roll!
We're gonna try something tonight that we've never done before.
Shut up, Robbie!
Bring out the best horn men in New York to help us do it.
Fuck you, Robbie! Let Rick sing! Richard! All right, shut up, Robbie. Play your fucking guitar. Richard, don't cry, Richard. What are we tuning up? This is a fucking dead show. Let's go. Oh, come on. Whose idea were the horns? Come on! Fuck you, Robbie. Seriously. Fuck you. Yeah, leave on! Rick!
Don't you break my heart? I'll be
Yes. I've lived this song. I've also been on both sides of that. I've been left and I've done the leaving. They both suck. Okay, so I gotta get it together. Buster? Yeah. Well, I'm glad that people came by. I know it was a surprise. Everything's going good. Any questions before? What? What's up? God damn it. I thought we were over the drugs. I thought we were over the drugs. There, just do it then. Use whatever options you have at your disposal to maintain your sanity without hurting yourself or others. Too close? You know who I miss when I'm on set? Because she believed in me and she made me feel like I could do this more than anybody else. Lynn Shelton, the woman who occupied that hat and that jacket and those boots. It was her belief in me that made me believe in myself. True. After a long life, after many years of faking it. All right. I gotta oil my shoes. Buddha face. Have a good day.